In this video, we're going to tell you how to tell a compelling story with data. Visualizing data and telling a meaningful story with it allows businesses to make smarter decisions. This is why it's such a critical part of the data analytics process. You'll also be presenting data to people who don't have an understanding of data. That's why it's important to be clear, articulate, and concise when presenting this data. For this tutorial, we're joined again, once again, by Dr. Humera, and she's going to take you through the key steps of how to craft a compelling story. Over to you, Dr. Humera.
Hi, everyone. This is Humera, and I've been associated with data analysis for over 20 years, both in the academia and in the industry. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about how to tell compelling data stories. We have already seen in the previous tutorial how to create visualizations. And now it's the time to basically use those visualizations and tell a compelling story. Storytelling is very important. It's really vital for a data analyst to be a good storyteller. This is because you basically want to convince your audience to take certain actions based on the data that you have found. So let's dive deeper into this tutorial and I'll show you how to craft a compelling story using data. To tell a compelling story, there are three key elements. The first one is data. You have already worked with the data. And the second one is visualization. You have your visualizations ready as well. Now, the third element is missing, which is making a good story, making a good narration out of it. As I mentioned, this is actually important because you want to use this data and this information to convince your audience to basically make certain decisions. And this basically brings me to the first very important step of storytelling, identifying your audience. Identifying your audience is the first most important step because this will actually help you to set the tone and identify what kind of message you want to communicate. For example, the leadership team, they are more interested in the final outcomes and clear-cut patterns to make any decision. On the other hand side, the technical audience, your colleagues who are in the technical domain, they are more interested in getting the raw data and some raw insights into the data. So when you talk to both of these, the story that you are going to tell is going to be really different. And same goes for whether your audience is internal to the company or external to the company, whether you are talking to the clients or you are talking to the sales team or you are talking to the engineering team. So again, identifying your audience is really the first and the foremost step. The second is constructing a compelling narrative. You need to ask enrolling questions. By enrolling questions, we mean setting up the stage. We just saw the example of New York Taxi. What we can do with those findings? Who is interested in which kind of information? So for example, are we talking about who is interested in identifying the number of pickup locations and the frequency of rides that initiate from certain pickup locations versus who is more interested in the payment types that we are offering? These are two different types of questions. And the people responsible are going to make decisions on the basis of the right data that you are showing them. I want to quote Simon Sinek here. In his famous TED talk, Start With Why, he strongly advocates that one should always start with the why and the purpose of their story. This actually helps us in engaging our audience. We don't want to leave the audience hanging with the question, why am I being told this information? If you start presenting your data without setting the stage, you're not going to engage your audience. So setting up the stage is important. The third step is creating and organizing your data visualizations. Here we need to be very careful. Before we create a story, we are generating lots of visualization, lots of data. But all the data doesn't go into the story. You only pick and choose what makes sense. And you only pick and choose what fits best. A common trap that data analysts fall into is to put a lot of data into the slides and just leave the presentation in the form of a jumble of graphs. We don't want to have that. So you need to identify which information actually makes sense and fits best into the story. A very good practice is to connect each visualization with a question. This is exactly what we did in the previous tutorials. We had certain questions. For example, what is the frequency of different pickup locations? How does passenger counts relate to trip distances, and so on and so forth. It makes your story compelling if your visualizations are connected to such questions. This is how you are going to unfold your story. And finally, you connect all the dots. So now you know your audience. You have your visualizations in place. You have your narration in place. Now you need to connect all the dots. So you start with a proper enrolling question. What is it that we want to achieve as a strategic decision? And what individual questions do we need to answer to reach that conclusion? And that's basically it. And now you have a fair idea of how a data analytics pipeline looks like and what a data analyst does in their day-to-day lives. Just to recall, it's a simple five-step process. You start with collecting data and importing them to your favorite tool. You clean up the data. Then you move on to do some descriptive analysis and exploration. Then you do the visualizations. You prepare charts to visualize the data. And finally, you create a compelling story from your data. If you have any more questions, feel free to reach out. And I wish you all the best. Congratulations on completing these five tutorials. You should be very proud of yourself. Whether or not you decide to pursue a career as a data analyst, I'm positive you have certainly learned some valuable skills that can be applied to almost any career path. I'll hand it back to Will now. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial as much as I did.
Thank you so much, Humera. Wow, what a journey it's been. We've covered so much in the past five tutorials. Just to recap, this was all part of CareerFoundry's Data Analytics Short Course. Depending on where you joined us in the tutorials, you can click the link below and you can start on day one so you can cover all the material that we've covered in the past five tutorials. I really look forward to hearing about your data analytics journey in the comments below. We really hope you've enjoyed these videos and hopefully it's set you up with a keen interest in data analytics and potentially even a career. If you want even more information, CareerFoundry has a fantastic blog where there's an abundance of articles about data analytics. It's great for further information. I'd like to take a moment just to thank Dr. Humera for all the fantastic insights over the past five tutorials. It's really been a journey and we're so thankful to have had her here. And remember to subscribe to the CareerFoundry YouTube channel to see more videos just like this. We hope you've enjoyed these lessons. See you again soon.